Spinning electrons effortlessly dance their way through new materials. Even without moving themselves, they are able to send information. They make communicating with just ones and zeros belong to the past, creating a whole new era of microprocessing. Smaller, faster, and energy efficient. While the potential of spinning electrons is huge, towing them in line seems a big challenge. Bart van Wees masters the taming of spinning electrons. He and his Physics of Nanodevices team, part of the Zernike Institute of Advanced Materials at the University of Groningen, own the world record in spin control and transport, leading the world of spintronics. Every time you switch on an electronic device like your cell phone, your car, or your computer, electrons start moving through microprocessors. In these processors, tiny switches known as transistors function by letting electrons pass or not, thereby communicating with zeros and ones. Over the decades, the size of electronic components has shrunk ever more, producing ever more powerful microprocessors. But increasing the power of microprocessors increases energy consumption and heat production, which is becoming too much to handle. So in order to keep developing at the same pace, we need innovative, more efficient, and more powerful devices on a nanoscale. Driven by curiosity and thinking with his hands, Bart van Wees experiments with graphene in order to find new ways of controlling spinning electrons under desktop conditions. Graphene is an excellent conductor of electrons and a very good conductor of electron spin. Spin is a quantum mechanical property of electrons, which makes them behave like very small compass needles. The spin of an electron has a direction and can point up or down or in between. So spin can be used to transfer information even through an insulator. But the spin signal is very small, making it difficult to handle. In a recent breakthrough, Bart van Wees found a way to increase this signal by 100 times. He has now shown how to transport a spin signal bigger than ever before, further than ever before. Furthermore, electron spin is what makes a material magnetic, so spin currents are a very natural way to read or write information to magnetic memory. The first magnetic memory chips based on spin currents may already be part of your mobile phone and computer within just 5 years. Due to his practical approach in this minuscule world of spinning electrons, Bart van Wees is bringing spintronics ever closer to your desk, your car, and your cell phone, making them work faster while using less energy.